Yo, 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 it's Joe from Photos with Phones. Today we're here to talk about smartphone macro photography. Let's get to it. What is smartphone macro photography? This is smartphone macro photography. If you're talking to a photography purist, macro photography is when you're taking photos and your subject is the same size or smaller than your camera's sensor. In layman's terms, however, this just means macro photography is when you take photos of really small things. The main reason that you would do this is so that you can capture those super fine details that you would otherwise miss. Examples of these details include the hairs on a bug, the reflections on a water droplet. You get the idea. We'll show you some examples right now. Alright, so you get the idea that macro photography is taking photos of super small things. And if you want to get super specific, it's taking photos of things that are smaller than the size of your camera's sensor. So, if you're going to talk intelligently about smartphone macro photography, there are two terms that you need to keep in mind. The first term is magnification. This is kind of self-explanatory, but if your phone's camera is a wide-angle lens, it's just one time magnified. If you have a telephoto lens, like on my iPhone 11 Pro, that is a two times magnified lens. So, I shoot my smartphone macro photography with the Moment 10X lens. So, if I mount that lens on the wide angle on my iPhone 11 Pro, that's a 10 times magnification. However, if I mount the Moment 10X macro lens on my iPhone's telephoto lens, which is two times magnification, that's a total of 20 times magnification. So, keep that in mind. The other important term that you're going to need to keep in mind for smartphone macro photography is working distance. Typically, for macro lenses for your phone, the working distance is 1 inch. This means that you need to be within 1 inch of your subject in order to get crisply in focus photos and videos. Now, unfortunately, this kind of sucks if you want to do macro photography of bugs and other small animals, because if you get 1 inch away from them, they tend to freak out and run away. But there are still uses for smartphone macro lenses. I've showed you some already. It's time to show you some more. Now, we'll move on to how to do smartphone macro photography. Now, there are a few phones on the global market that have built-in macro lenses. They are all terrible. Unfortunately, they just haven't developed the in-phone camera technology to have an efficient macro lens, and in the United States, good luck having Apple or Samsung include something like that, but just so that we're clear, they do exist in camera. There are also some hacks that are mildly successful, and if you'd like me to do a full video on that, drop a comment down there letting me know. In my experience, because I have done the hack before, it doesn't really work very well, and you can get better results by spending even $15 on something like a MagnaBand lens. If you don't know anything about MagnaBand, I'll drop a link down there in the description to our write-up on them. But essentially, this teenage kid in England developed a macro lens that attaches to like a rubber band kind of thing that goes around your phone, and it does a pretty good job. It does not do as good of a job as my Moment 10x macro lens. So in the end, how to do smartphone macro photography, you kind of have to get an external lens, unfortunately. Again, if you'd like me to show you how to do the different hacks out there, drop a comment down there and I'll certainly make a video for you. Alrighty, so now that we've established that to do great smartphone macro photography, you do have to pick up an external lens, I'll go ahead and explain to you when you should be doing that smartphone macro photography, because that's just as important. Now, for me personally, I'd love to do smartphone macro photography of flowers, leaves, things out in nature, because I don't know, it allows me to have a different perspective of those smaller things that I just wouldn't have experienced in that way, if that makes sense. There are also commercial uses for your smartphone macro photography. As I've mentioned multiple times in this video already, product photography and videography with a smartphone macro lens is a great way to make money. Do you have an Etsy or Shopify store and you want to get more detailed photos of your products without spending an arm and a leg? This is a great way to do it. If you need more information about product photography in general, we have a guide for that on the website, and I'll drop a link to it wherever it is. It's on one of these sides, so you get the point. I also love to use my macro lens and macro footage in my mobile filmmaking as well. It adds another focal point into the overall video and just gives another perspective and adds those intimate details that the native iPhone cameras don't add. So that's just a personal thing. Yeah. In summary, when to do smartphone macro photography is kind of up to you. In our opinion, it's great to do it of small animals, of flowers, of products, and in our mobile filmmaking. If you have any other uses for it, drop them down there in the comments. I'd love to hear about them. Let's move on. So, what are the best lenses for smartphone macro photography? Well, numero uno has to be the Moment 10x macro lens. For less than $100, you can get awesome macro footage like I've showed you thus far. And as always, Moment is top class with the customer service and just everything that they do. So you can't go wrong with that. Other options include MagnaBand, as I already mentioned, or there are other similar designs on Amazon. You just pick one out. I will go ahead and put the smartphone macro photography. I'll go ahead and link the smartphone photography guide from the website down in the description, where you can find more information about our favorite smartphone macro photography lenses. At this point, you may be saying, Joe, why don't I just get a DSLR or mirrorless camera and buy a macro lens for that? Well, that's gonna run you a couple $1,000s. This option is cost effective and high quality. You've seen the content that I've created, and I can assure you that it is not that difficult for you to do the same. So, head on over to the website and learn a little something. So we got for you. With all the information that we've given you in this guide, you can go out and be a great smartphone macro photographer yourself. If you feel like you got value from this video, please go ahead and hit the like button down there. It really helps Photos with Phones out a lot, because if you don't like the video, YouTube won't show it to other people. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel as well and turn on that notification bell. We post mobile photography, videography, tips, hacks, unboxings, reviews, everything that you can possibly imagine multiple times a week, and you should hear about it first. It'll just give you a leg up. So do it. Do it right now. I'm not gonna go anywhere until you do it. So you're gonna stay with me, and you can't leave. You can't hit the X button. You gotta, okay, all right, we're done.